Do you want to do the video with Patty?
Yeah.
Okay. We're going to move this out of the way so they can see.
Papi, look.
You have to put it on the side so they can see your face. Say hi. Can you say hi? Okay, today we're going to review a mouse.
Yeah?
Yeah? Okay, a mouse. Now, do you want to say something about the mouse?
No, the mouse is... That's nothing.
Okay, go ahead. Tell them about the mouse.
No, there's a book. There's a picture.
It's a picture of the mouse?
Yeah.
Okay, what color is the mouse?
It.
Huh? Is it blue?
Blue.
No, it's not blue. Is it white?
The white.
It's a white mouse. Okay. And what does this say here? What number is that?
Two.
Two. This is the V2. This is the Pulsar X2 version 2 Mini.
Papi, hold that. Papi. Papi, hold that.
A V2.
V2.
Do we open the box so we could show people what's inside?
Yeah.
Okay. You want to open the box?
Yeah.
Open. You just lift.
Yeah.
Wow. Is that the mouse?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, the button.
The button's on the side? Yeah, that's a wheel. Do you want to show what else comes in the box? Okay, what else is inside? Okay, you have the mouse. So you have the mouse, the white mouse, ergonomic mouse that comes inside. Okay, what else is inside? Open, open. What else is inside? Open it. What else is inside? You have a USB receiver with it?
No, see, like it. But the,
oh. Yeah, look, you have a USB and the receiver inside like this.
No, okay. No, okay.
And it comes with a charging cable. So you could use it. Pull, you can get it. Go. Pull. You have to show the camera though, you can't show yourself. So you're talking about, what are you talking about now? Are you talking about the fact that it's an ergonomic shape?
No, it's an ergonomic shape.
So is this a heavy mouse? Is it heavy or light? It's a very light mouse. It's only 55 grams.
Papi, look at your face.
Yeah, it's only 55 grams. What else about this mouse? What about the size of this mouse? But for you, it's a good size for you, no? You could use it? Yeah, you could use it well. So is it a good size for you or is it too big?
It's big, Daddy.
Here, try it on the mouse pad. How does it feel? Does it slide well? Try it like this. Here. Over here like this. Oh, wow. It also has a light underneath. You want to see the light?
Yeah.
Look, when you turn it on from underneath. Oh, you see the light. Looky. See the green light? There's a green light inside. That shows you what DPI you're on.
Look. Green.
Green. Yeah, the green light. So now we're going to say bye-bye. Can we say bye-bye?
Bye-bye.
Can you go like this? Bye-bye? Okay, so let's try this again tonight. I don't have my little helper with me, but she was awesome yesterday in helping me set this up, and she's sleeping tonight, so I'll be able to get through this a little more, I guess, classic, traditional way of reviewing a product. So there is no such thing as the perfect, the best mouse out there for all gamers. It's gonna be different depending on your hand size, your comfort level, your DPI setting, and how you just play the game. And that's why I'm always trying to strive and testing new mice to see if there's something that I could improve on what I'm currently using. So right now my main has been the Razer Viper Ultimate, the original one. This is the Xlite from Pulsar, the Xlite V2. So this is their second version of the Pulsar, and this is the mini version, so it's gonna be smaller than your standard size Xlite. So when you open the box, you get obviously the mouse. This is the white version. You have the USB dongle and the receiver here. It's USB-C, and that's also how you charge this mouse, USB-C, which is included. Obviously, you have a nice wire included here. The overview of this mouse. So this is the mini. It is a smaller shape. It is their size number one, which you could see here at the bottom. It says size one. Ergonomic shape, so it does have the little indent on the left-hand side for control and comfort on your thumb, so it's only made for right-handed users. You do still have that, you know, I'm gonna call it honeycomb shape, but that hollow shell It is a one piece, it does feel pretty solid plastic, and it is a super lightweight mouse at 55 grams. When I weighed it, it showed 56, but easy margin of error depending on the scale. So you do have the holes here right at the edge over here and on top to make it a bit lighter. They did change that from the previous version where it was grills all along the side. So this way here it's solid and then the grills are only in the front. That gives you more comfort and control. Now versus the original version, the mouse wheel is a bit more raised this time, so it is a bit easier to access and you do have more control over it without touching the mouse buttons at the same time. So that's something that I thoroughly enjoyed. And the feet are full PTFE, they glide really well. There is an option to purchase like additional maybe glass skates and stuff on their website, I think as an add-on accessory, but overall I find this glides really well. This is USB-C and it claims that it is a 1 millisecond no lag full response time, and I did not have any issues with lag for a wireless mouse. I think we've gotten to the point where like people that are complaining that wireless versus wired mice are gonna have a better lag free experience with a wired mice. I think technology has come far enough that we've seen so many high quality wireless mice that we know that's just not true. There's no additional performance benefit going wired except the fact that you don't have to charge your mouse. But to be honest, like this one, Pulsar claims that there's a 70 hour battery life on it. I've never got to the point where I've had to stop mid game because my mouse died. It's USB-C, but I just charge it every couple of days and I was good to go. The sensor is the Pulsar brand new 3370 sensor up to 20K DPI, which to be honest, I don't know anybody who gains that 20K DPI. I'm at 800 DPI and that's more than enough for me. So even getting to 1,000 I could play with, but I start to feel the speed. I can't even imagine somebody that plays at 20,000 DPI. This hardware is actually pretty good. I had no issues with it. By changing the DPI, you assign a color to it. So when you change, that's the real RGB on this mouse. When you change your DPI setting in the mouse is when you're gonna change the color. So right now I had it to green for 800. But if I would go into the software and change it to like 1,000, it would go to blue. So that's your RGB right there, I guess, is just based on what DPI you're using. So this is the mini version. So it's somebody that might have maybe a smaller hand. So if we look at the length of it, it's 4.6 inches from top to bottom, and then 2.52 inches from left to right, with obviously a weight of 55 grams. Like I said, my hand is about 19 by 10, 20 by 10. And if you just see here, with a claw grip, it is perfectly comfortable. I have no problem using this mouse. So this mouse, if you go on the Pulsar website, it's $80 US to purchase it. And I think that's a really fair price compared to other products and other mice that are out there. When you're looking at something like a Razer Viper Ultimate that gets really expensive, like a G Pro Superlight, they really get expensive with price. And I think $80 US is a really good price point for, actually it's a great price point for a really good premium quality mouse. And I don't want to say it's a value mouse, but it's a good, you're getting a lot of value for the $80 is what I want to say. And I really enjoyed using an ergonomic mouse. I know this is kind of like a preference thing, but if I look back on the mice that I've been using like in the past, so this was the Xtrfy M4, another ergonomic mouse, and this was probably one of my favorite. This is my favorite wired mouse there is, and it's super comfortable to use with the big buttons. So that was one of them. And then I did go obviously the symmetrical route. So we had the Phone Ultra Custom Sim, and then the one I've been using the most, the Razer Viper Ultimate. And I do enjoy the symmetrical mice, but there is something about an ergonomic mouse that I think naturally for me, it's more comfortable. The only benefit, and I think one of the main reasons why I've kept the Viper Ultimate for so long, is really the charging dock. And it's not even like a big deal for a lot of people. For me it is, it's just super easy to just place it on when it's done. But having this as USB-C is a lot easier because this is micro USB to charge, and I don't have micro USB on my setup, but I do have USB-C because my phone is USB-C, the mouse is USB-C, my keyboards are USB-C. So the Ledger that I use, Ledger Nano, is USB-C. So there is USB-C wires already connected on my desk. So it's very easy for me to plug this at the end of the day to charge it when I log off. Anyways guys, that'll do it for this one. Hopefully you enjoyed this little quick review of the Xlite V2 from Pulsar, and I hope you enjoyed the little beginning when I tried to do the review with my 2-year-old daughter. Hopefully you guys had some laughs with that. I had fun actually. So yeah, that'll do it for this one guys. Like, subscribe, comment, and I will catch you guys next time.